closer of the chamber music series here at Rise Church. The ensemble on stage here has been preparing for the last few months, although sporadically. The inspiration for this is, of course, this wonderful recent composition by James Stevenson. If any of you are fans of the Oregon Ballet Theater, last night they closed their set of his ballet Wooden Dimes, originally written for the San Francisco Ballet, and he was in town to conduct it, so I thought we should prepare this new composition and have him come and work with the students, which he did, and it was inspiring to have the creator of this remarkable piece, this unusual instrumentation on stage. This was originally an instrumentation conceived in a dream by Igor Stravinsky, who wrote about 100 years ago an octet for winds with these same instruments, which is a classic of the wind repertoire. Every wind conductor has to learn its intricate meter changes, and every bassoonist, whether they play first or second, has to sweat over the very difficult parts that he wrote for the instrument and many other things. So Jim decided he would not spare anybody difficulties in this piece. It is an extraordinary virtuoso work in both assembling and execution. So I'm very proud of the work these students have done to prepare it for you today, as I am for all of the ensembles you will hear. It's worth noting that there are several concerts left in the Philharmonic and PYP season, the next one being May the 5th, when all of the ensembles, in other words, all of the musicians you see today will perform, because all of our groups will perform brand new compositions composed for their particular ensemble, except for the Philharmonic, which will take the stage to play Charles Griffith's poem for flute and orchestra with Macy Gong as soloist. And then the PYP season itself will conclude on May 31st with Hugh Edwards as guest conductor, which will include Schubert's Unfinished Symphony, a work played at the very first PYP concert, as well as Thomas Lauderdale and Hunter Nowak performing Rhapsody in Blue, another work 100 years old, premiered in 1924 with the Philharmonic. So don't miss that. We appreciate everything that those of you who are parents and students do for us, and thank you for being here, and enjoy James Stevenson's Octet for Winds. one small correction. We are beginning with Danny Boy.
Thank you. I Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.